Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about epsilon NFA. Epsilon means empty string, and NFA can change its state from one to another without reading an input symbol. This is called as epsilon NFA. We can formally represent epsilon NFA with 5 tuples similar to NFA. Epsilon NFA E is equal to Q sigma delta Q naught F. So where E represents a name of the epsilon NFA, Q means finite set of states, sigma finite set of input symbols, Q naught start state, F set of final or accepting states. So these are similar to NFA only, and the only difference is in the transition function. So delta of Q comma A equals P1 P2 dot dot up to PK. That is, it takes current state and current input as an argument, and it returns any number of states. It may have any number of transitions from the current state for a particular input, similar to NFA. But only difference is in the second argument of delta. So this A may be either an input symbol in sigma, input symbol in sigma, set of input alphabet, or it may be epsilon. So this is the only difference between epsilon NFA and NFA. Now we will see one example, construction of epsilon NFA for decimal numbers. So the set of strings may be, decimal number means it may be minus 467.35, positive number, it may be a positive decimal number, or plus 467.35. So positive number can be given like 467.35 or plus 467.35, likewise. Okay, so these are all the decimal numbers must be accepted by our epsilon NFA. So we will start constructing the epsilon NFA for this. Assume that Q naught is a start state of the epsilon NFA. So the first input symbol of the decimal number may be a sign. It may be a minus, plus, or optional. So from state Q naught to Q 1, there must be a transition labeled by plus, minus, or epsilon. That is, if you consider the second input without reading the sign, it should change the state from Q naught to Q 1. It is start reading from 4, right? So it will follow epsilon transition to go from Q0 to Q1, to reach Q1. Then the sign is followed by one or more digits, right? For representing digits, we can use 0 to 9. So for one digit, the state changed from Q1 to Q2, 0, 1, dot, dot, up to 9. So this is representing any one digit. So if it reads 4, then it changed state from Q1 to Q2. So it represents 0 or 1 or 2 up to 9. So one digit, by reading one digit, the epsilon NFA change its state from Q1 to Q2. So after one digit followed by number of digits. So some number of digits means we need to draw self transition, and it is labeled by 0 to 9. So a single digit followed by number of digits, because this is not optional, no. So single digit followed by number of digits, this is the transition. Then dot, so for the decimal point, it changes state from Q2 to Q3. Then after the dot, in all cases, again it reads the string of digits, sequence of digits. So this may be represented by 0 to 9. So, and one more rule is, either the first string of digit or the second string of digits, that is the digits before decimal point or digits after decimal point, may be optional. That is dot 354 or 467 dot, are also the valid numbers, decimal numbers. So we are going to consider these conditions also. So if you consider first string of digit optional, that is starts with dot alone, means after this epsilon, after following epsilon transition, we will be in state Q1. So it starts reading dot. So another transition, another path is dot followed by. So if the first string of digit is optional, then the second string of digits must be there in the decimal number. So one digit after the decimal point, one digit followed by string of digits. So if first string of digit is optional, then it follows this path. Second string of digit is optional, then this it follows this path. Suppose if you consider 467, then it will follow epsilon 467 dot. Then from Q3 to Q5, draw an epsilon transition, and we are going to consider Q5 as a final state. By following epsilon transition, Q3 changes its state from Q3 to Q5. So if you consider the first example, the state transition are minus 467.35 epsilon, so it reaches Q5. Similarly, 467.35 epsilon 467.35 epsilon. Next, we will find epsilon closes for a particular state. So it can be, it is represented like E close of Q. E close of Q means following all epsilon transitions out of Q. So for the previous example, we can write the E closer for all states. So E close of Q naught can be found by first writing Q naught. If you want to find E closer for any state, first you have to write that state. Then check whether any epsilon transitions out of Q naught. From Q naught, there is an epsilon transition goes to Q1 for the state Q1. So include Q1 also in the E close of Q naught. Then check from Q1, is there any epsilon transitions? From Q1, there is no outgoing epsilon transitions. So E close of Q0 is Q0, Q1. Similarly, we have to find E closer for all states. E closer of Q1 means first write Q1, then check, is there any epsilon transitions from Q1? There is no epsilon transition. So E closer of Q1 is Q1. Then for E closer of Q2, write Q2, then check, is there any epsilon transitions out of Q2? No. Then for E closer of Q3, first write Q3, then check, is there any epsilon transitions out of Q3? There is an epsilon transition goes to Q5 from Q3. So include Q5 also, then check, is there any epsilon transition from Q5? No. So E closer of Q3 is Q3, Q5. Then for E closer of Q4, check, is there any epsilon transitions out of Q4? No. So only Q4. Then from Q5, there is no epsilon transitions. So E closer of Q5 is Q5. So this is E closer for the previous example. Thank you.